Hey guys.
Hey Bo.
Hi Bo.
Flippin' physics.
Ladies and gentle people, the bell has rung, therefore class has begun, therefore you should be seated in your seats, ready and excited to graph the drop of a medicine ball.
Yes.
Yep.
Where's my calculator?
In our previous lesson, we took the medicine ball and we dropped it from a height of 2.0 meters, and we knew the initial velocity of the y direction was equal to zero, the acceleration of the y direction, because it was in free fall, was negative 9.81 meters per second squared, and the displacement in the y direction was negative 2.0 meters, negative because it was going down. We used our uniformly accelerated motion equations to determine the final velocity in the y direction was approximately negative 6.3 meters per second, again, negative because it was going down, and the change in time was approximately 0.64 seconds. What we're going to do today is we are going to graph the position, velocity, and acceleration as a function of time graphs for the drop of this ball as it moves down the 2.0 meters. Now, one of these three graphs we should know right away. Who can tell me which one?
Acceleration versus time. The acceleration is constant at negative 9.81 meters per second squared, so it's just a straight line.
I think you actually mean a horizontal line. And where should I draw this horizontal line?
Right, a horizontal line at negative 9.81 meters per second squared, because that's the value of the constant acceleration.
Great, now let's work on our velocity versus time graph. Class, what is the slope of a velocity versus time graph?
Acceleration.
Right, the slope of a velocity versus time graph is acceleration. Therefore, Bo, what do we know about this velocity versus time graph?
Because the value of the acceleration graph is constant, that means that the slope of the line is going to be a constant negative 9.81 meters per second squared. So the line looks like this. We also know that the initial velocity is equal to zero, therefore we should start at the origin.
Absolutely, the initial velocity was zero, so we start there with the initial velocity of zero, and the slope of the line is going to be negative 9.81 meters per second squared, so we're going to have a straight line with a slope of negative 9.81 meters per second squared. Actually, we also know that the final velocity was negative 6.3 meters per second, so we can add that to the graph. Oh, and we also know the total change in time was 0.64 seconds, so we can also add that to the graph. Now we need to work on our position as a function of time graph. Billy, please tell me something we know about position.
We know the initial and final positions. At 0 seconds, the ball is 2.0 meters off the ground, and at 0.64 seconds, the ball is on the ground, so 0 meters off the ground.
Right. We know where it starts, and we know where it ends. We just need to know what happens between those 2 points. So remind me, class, what's the slope of a position versus time graph?
Velocity.
Right. And Bobby, how does it help us to figure out our position as a function of time graph to know that the slope of the position versus time graph is velocity?
Well, the initial velocity is zero, therefore the initial slope of the position graph should be zero. And the velocity gets more and more negative as time goes by, so that is what the slope of the position graph should do. So it'll look like this.
Sure.
Yes, I can show, using my magic tangent line finder, that the initial slope is equal to zero. And as time goes by, the slope of the tangent line gets to be more and more negative.
Exactly right.
Any questions?
Nope.
No thanks.
Great, let's do a quick review. We started with the acceleration as a function of time graph because it was the easiest. The acceleration was constant, therefore we have a horizontal line at a value of negative 9.81 meters per second squared. Coming to the velocity as a function of time graph, because the slope of a velocity versus time graph is acceleration, we knew that the slope of the velocity versus time graph was going to be constant and have a value of negative 9.81 meters per second squared. In addition to that, we knew the initial velocity in the y direction was equal to zero, therefore we could draw the line for velocity as a function of time. Because the slope of a position versus time graph is velocity, we knew that we needed to start with an initial slope of zero because the initial velocity was equal to zero. In addition to that, we knew we started at 2 meters and ended at 0 meters. And as time went by, the velocity got to be more and more negative. Therefore, the slope of the position as a function of time graph also got more and more negative. Ladies and gentle people, thank you for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.